Support for the Nature Museum is provided by Rose Pest Solutions, protecting homes, businesses, health, and the environment since 1860.
Hi, everybody, and welcome to a special Animal Crossing episode of Curious by Nature. My name is Alan, and today we're going to talk about four different bugs that can be found while playing the game in March. Some colleagues and I have spent time volunteering for the Animal Crossing Museum, collecting and donating bugs, fish, and fossils, and they noticed some similarities between bugs they found in-game recently and insects they've seen here in the real world, even recognizing several from in and around the Peggy Notebaert Nature Museum. Since I work with insects at the Nature Museum, I've invited them today to ask some questions about what bugs they've seen, to learn more about them, and see how they compare to their in-game counterparts. Hi, Janelle. Thank you so much for sitting down with me today.
I'm so happy to, Alan.
So could you remind me, what is your role here at the museum?
I am the web and social media director.
What is the first insect you saw in game that you recognized from the museum?
Well, it's funny because in the game, it's called a paper kite butterfly, but I know it as a rice paper butterfly. Are those the same butterfly?
Yeah, they're the same thing. They just have multiple common names. We like to use scientific names too, so the scientific name for this is Idea lucano.
Okay, so an insect can have multiple common names, but it'll just have the same scientific name across the board.
Yeah, correct. And I think we're going to see this with other insects we talk about today as well.
Blathers said in the game that part of the reason they're colored that way is to let animals know they're poisonous. Is that true?
Yeah, that's very true. So you see they have this really striking black and white coloration. That's a warning pattern, and also called aphosomatic coloration, and that's to let predators know, don't eat me, you're probably gonna get sick. They have a chemical defense. They sequester poisons from the host plants they eat, so that means that they store them in their body tissues. They feed on a plant called Parsonia, and the Parsonia produces compounds called pyrrolizidine alkaloids, which are toxic to eat. So now they're not poisonous just as an adult butterfly. They are gathering these chemicals as a caterpillar, so they're gonna start protecting them in that life stage. And they save those chemicals through pupation, so as a chrysalis as well, when they're gold and black. And then when they emerge to be an adult butterfly, they're still protected. The adult butterflies, when they lay eggs, they'll include some of those compounds to help protect them as well.
They're literally poisonous at every stage of their life.
Yeah, so they're chemically defended in every life stage.
It's funny though, because its coloring kind of reminds me of a monarch, even though it's white and black. Is that the same thing that monarchs do to let animals know that they're poisonous?
Yeah, it's the same idea. So monarchs are doing the same thing. They're storing cardiac glycosides from the milkweeds they eat as a caterpillar, and those help protect them. And their color patterns are pretty similar because they're not too distantly related to each other as far as butterflies go.
Okay.
So you had mentioned to me that there was another insect you had seen.
Yeah, actually I think I just started noticing them maybe this month or last month. They're called tiger beetles.
So the one in game is most likely the Japanese tiger beetle. Cincindela chinensis japonica is the scientific name there. We're not going to have that species here, but we're going to have several others that look just like them.
You know, I think I've seen one maybe when I was visiting my sister. It was a little bit different color, but it was kind of the same shape.
So you can tell something's a tiger beetle because they have this really distinct shape with these large bulgy eyes and kind of long bodies and long legs. Now, when you donated it to Blathers, what did he have to say about it?
He said that they're maybe called a tiger beetle because they're ferocious predators like a tiger. I don't know if that's true or not, though.
They are ferocious predators, and they have very large jaws that are great for grasping and grabbing prey, and they're also extremely fast, so they can sprint and hunt down prey. In the game, you may notice when you chase after them, they kind of run and stop, and then run a little bit and stop. They also will do that when they're chasing down prey, and it's thought that they're moving so fast, just the visual flow of information is a little disorienting, so they have to stop periodically to sort of get their bearings, and then they can sprint again.
Oh.
So they're really moving too fast to see where they're going.
Wow, that's really cool.
They'll do that outside too. They seem to know exactly how far you can reach. And if I have a net, they seem to be a little bit further away. So they like sandy habitats, so you're often gonna find them on beaches. So when I go to Lake Michigan or the Montrose Dunes, I find them there all the time. But sometimes I even find them on sidewalks. And they'll run away, and they can even fly away too, and they'll just like go a few feet and then land.
Are they actually harmful to humans?
There's no reason to be scared. They're not harmful to humans at all. Now, they do have really large jaws, so if you were to pick one up and handle it in a way it didn't like, it could bite you. But they're so fast and shy, good luck getting your hands on one. Hi, Airen. Thank you so much for sitting down to chat with me today. Can you remind me what you do at the museum?
Absolutely. I work in the guest engagement department as the program development specialist, and I often work with bugs, so I'm very curious about them.
So what was the first one?
Well, I caught a mantis recently, and Blathers told me that mantises eat other bugs and spiders, and they have sickle-like arms. Is any of that true?
Yeah, that is all true. The one they have in game is most likely the Chinese mantis, Tenodera sinensis. So those are non-native to the U.S., but they've been introduced since late 1800s. So you can find them around here. Mantises are voracious predators, and they're mostly eating insects and spiders. That's their primary diet. And they capture them with their raptorial-like front legs. So they hold them close to the body, and they wait patiently, and then when something comes by, they can quickly reach out and grab it.
Whoa, that's really neat. So if I remember correctly, I think Blathers said that they tend to eat bugs and spiders, and mantises have been known to dine on small animals too.
Blathers. So we both know that bugs and spiders are animals. But what I think he was getting at was mantises have been known to eat vertebrates too. So not just invertebrates like insects. So things, small things with a backbone. So even like small birds,
really?
Tiny rodents,
like
on occasion. On occasion.
Wow, that is really cool. The mantises that I've been finding on my island are often in the flower beds, and they're bright green. Are they always bright green, or do they change colors?
Mantises can be green or brown, and they can't change their color like a chameleon, but when they shed their skin and molt, the cuticle underneath can be a different color. So they can go from green to brown in their lifespan.
Blathers said that mantises have 5 eyes. I'm only seeing 2 eyes. Is it true that they have 5?
Yeah, that is very true. So mantises, being predators, have really good vision. So you're gonna notice their big compound eyes on the side of their head. This is what lets them see motion and resolve images really well. But they also have 3 smaller ocelli on the top of their head. Those are simple eyes that really just help them sort of see light and dark and maybe some color.
So that's why they're so hard to catch in the game.
Yeah, they can really see all around them. Mantises are also pretty unique as far as insects go, because they can not only rotate their head, but they can lift it up and down too, so they can kind of just turn their head to look at you from any direction.
So I was hitting rocks with my shovel one day, and all of a sudden, a really small bug pops up and crawls away. Blathers told me it was called a pill bug, and then it often rolls up when it's scared. Why does it roll up?
Yeah, so what you found is a pill bug. And pill bugs are a type of isopod. You've also seen these around the museum too, right?
So sometimes they'll come out for daily programs with me for kiddos, and sometimes I see them just outside on the Nature Museum grounds.
Yeah, so have you noticed those that use for programming, they don't all roll up?
So they don't. They kind of lay flat, and it seems like they have different sections of their body. It almost looks like armor.
Yeah, the ones that are kind of flatter don't really roll up, also known as wood lice. These are all isopods. The armadillo deity can roll up.
Whoa, that is a great word. Yeah, you say it again.
Armadillo deity. So they roll up just as a defense, a lot like an armadillo. They kind of have these armored scales, mm-hmm. and they form a complete ball, and then you can't really get at them.
Okay, what exactly are they hiding from? Other bugs or birds or both?
Yeah, both. Other bugs, spiders, birds, just things that like to eat little critters, basically. They're a type of isopod, and isopods are a type of crustacean.
Does that mean they're related to crabs and lobsters?
It does. That means they're in the same group of organisms as crabs and lobsters. The ones we're talking about they're terrestrial, so they live in soil. But there are some that live in the ocean and some that live in freshwater as well.
That's very cool.
That wraps up this edition of Curious by Nature, Exploring Bugs of Animal Crossing. I hope you enjoyed learning more about these creatures' real-world counterparts along with us. I'd love to hear if you found any yourself. Be sure to tell us about them in the comments below. Are there other Animal Crossing critters that you're curious about? let us know, and we'll consider covering them in a future episode. Don't forget to give this video a like, and be sure to subscribe to the Nature Museum's channel so you never miss an episode.